2013.
All right, it's going.
A bunch of locals out there. Does anybody have a question? 22, 23. Well, this will be a quick session. Okay, in class today we covered RCs, right? We covered circuits, combining resistors working backwards. We also covered a couple, like two-wire magnetics. I think we covered that in both sections, so you had a review today already. Are there other sections that were a little unclear about? Okay, so we'll combine capacitors and then
find the, like,
and work backwards. Okay. All right. So, can you see? Am I? We're good, kind of there.
Yeah.
Like number three.
Yes.
Yeah.
What are the different ways we're going to be getting on these type of problems? Like, are we going to be getting how to combine them in series and in parallel?
Yeah, you get CP equals CS equals.
Okay.
You get Q equals CV.
And then the R one, like, you know, right, you just put all those two.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
What are we just doing here? These are all in microfarad, and we'll use 10 volts. Keep everything simple. Call this 1, 2, 3. How's that? Okay, so we're going to ask what's going on each capacitor. We need to know what? The charge in each capacitor and the voltage across each capacitor. Okay. What's our first step? Identify anything in series. How about anything in series with this?
No.
No. Anything in series with that?
No.
Anything in series with that?
Yes.
Sure. The 2, the 20, and the 80 combined here. These go in series. How do we combine capacitors that are in series? It's the 1 over 1 over.
Can you do the same thing?
Okay. Or if there's just two of them, it's the product over the sum. If you actually manipulate this algebraically, it's the product over the sum. So, can somebody tell me what 20 times 80 is over 20 plus 80?
16.
16. And it'd be microfarads. Okay. All right. So these two, 20 and 80, combine together to form a capacitor that's 16 microfarads. How does that compare with my rule of thumb? So is it less than the smallest? Yes. And is it bigger than half of the smallest? Okay, it is. So the smallest is 20 picofarad. It's less than that, but it's bigger than half of that, which would be 10 picofarad. So it's 16. So these two combine into one. Before we do that, let me ask, what's the same on these two capacitors, the charge or the voltage or both?
Charge,
because they're in series. Series is end-to-end, no branches. Current or charge is the same. Series is end-to-end, no branches. Charge and current is the same. Okay, memorize that.
Wait, you say current and charge are the same for both?
For series, yeah.
For series, and then for parallel.
Parallel. Both ends are connected together with metal to metal on both ends. Voltage is the same. So now that we move to picture two, what do we got going on here?
Parallel.
40 and 16 are parallel. How do we combine parallel capacitors? They add. Okay. So 40 and 16 add to 56 together. Okay. What do we do now? Are these series or parallel? Series, so they combine 1 over 1 over 10. Successfully combined all our capacitors into one equivalent capacitor. Now what do we do? We're going to work backwards from here, going back that way, one step at a time. Please do not try to make multiple steps at a time. The whole key to your success is take it one step at a time. What do we know here? We know C and V, so we don't know
Q.
Q. Q equals what?
3 delta V.
Okay. So the charge on this is equal to 15 microfarads times 10 volts. I'm going to just say 150 microcoulombs. Does that work? 150 microcoulombs. That's how much charge comes out of the power supply altogether to drive the entire circuit. Yeah. Okay. Questions? All right. What do we take from here to use over here? What do I know about this capacitor? It's in series. So I took one capacitor and went like this. So these two must have the same charge. That charge is the same. So this is charged with 150 microcoulombs. This is charged with 150 microcoulombs. Sure. We know their values. Do we know their voltage?
No.
No, I don't know their voltage. So the voltage should equal the charge over the capacitance. That's 150 microcoulombs. Over 20 microfarads, let's cancel and we get 7.5 volts. Is that right? That's the voltage across here. The charge for these two capacitors is the same as the charge for this. Now, that's not commonsensical. What happens? Well, the power supply spits out a bunch of electrons. They go and line up on this plate, make the bottom plate negative. That pushes the same amount of electrons away from the top plate. They move up to this one, and then that pushes the same amount over to the power supply. So you end up with this amount of charge on all the plates of the capacitor. Does that make sense? the voltage across this?
2.5.
Should be 2.5. So we know from Kirchhoff's voltage law that this voltage minus this equals 0. So these two have to add up to 10, so we know it's 2.5. We could also check it. What's 150 divided by 56?
2.67.
2.67? I would like it to come a little closer.
Yeah.
Do we have a rounding error here of some kind?
No, it's exact. It's fine.
Yeah, that one's exact, isn't it? Is this really 15? 20 times 56?
No, it's
14
points.
Yeah.
14.74.
Well, that's not too far. My guess is it helps, if it's enough. So this will go down a little bit, and that will go up a little bit?
735.
735?
Yeah.
2.63. 2.63. And those are closer. I like that better. Okay. So 7.35 plus 2.6 is about 10 volts. It's Kirchhoff's voltage law that tells us that they should add up to 10 volts. Questions on this? Okay. Now, what do I do in taking this 56 microfarad capacitor and splitting it like this? What stays the same? I take it in the two.
Voltage.
The voltage. So this voltage here, I'm going to get rid of that. This voltage here is 2.63 volts. Okay? So what don't I know about this capacitor? Charge. So Q40, the amount of charge on that capacitor is equal to C40 delta V, which is equal to 40 microfarads times 2.63 volts. Okay. Maybe I get to do that.
1.05 times 10 to the negative 4.
1.05, so 105 times 10 to the minus
6.
Coulombs. So 105 microcoulombs. Does that make sense? What do we do next? We have to find the charge on the 16 microfarad cap. That's going to equal 16 microfarads times 2.63 volts. That's going to be 42 microcoulombs. Does that make sense? Any questions on what we're doing here?
So for all of them, we need to find the Qs and the Vs, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, when you're done, you want to know Q, C, and V on every component. Yes, as we go this way, we're finding C's, intermediate C's, and then as we go this way, we're finding all the Q's and V's. That's correct.
Because
Systematically, very methodical thing. You can not know anything about anything, but the methodology is doable.
Do you think on the test you give us like that whole thing to do, or did you just ask like specific questions that we do on practice tests? Like, what's the...
What's on one of them?
Yeah.
I don't know if I would. So the question was, would I ask, give you something complicated like this and say, find everything about everything, or would I ask something specific? It's a good question.
I don't know.
Or rather, I don't remember what I did on the test. Okay, so now we know everything about this, but we know C and Q and V on everything. What about over here? Well, we're taking the 16 and we're splitting it into a 20 and an 80. So what's the same on the 20 and 80?
Charge.
And what is the charge? 42 microcoulombs. So each of these capacitors here has 42 microcoulombs. Of charge. So I can find the voltage on them by taking the charge divided by the C. So the 16 is broken into a 20 and an 80 together. Yeah. And then the other one would be, hopefully you can calculate that while I do this. What's 42 divided by 20? 2.1 volts. And 42 divided by 80?
0.58.
And they add up to 2.63 volts, which is the voltage across them. Okay. And you might not realize it because we're so confused now that we did all this, but now you know everything about everything. This capacitor was fully described over there. This one over here. And then these two right here. So you've actually found everything. Does that make sense? All right, I'm going to hit stop.
No problem.